determine whether x and y show direct variation, inverse variation, or neither. Now, direct variation is y equals kx. And that means the variation constant k, and constant means it's always the same value, is going to be, so you divide by x on both sides, y divided by x equals k. All right, so if we want to figure out if there's direct variation, we can figure out y divided by x. And for inverse variation, we have y equals k divided by x. And so that one, to solve for k, I just made a little proportion and cross multiply yx equals k times 1, or k equals y times x. So I can do yx here, or you could do xy if you prefer to put them in alphabetical order. So what we're going to do is, based on these table values, we're going to figure out whether we have a constant ratio for y divided by x or y times x, and that will help us determine whether we have a direct or inverse variation, or perhaps neither, if neither of these has a pattern. So let's do y divided by x. Negative 6 divided by 3 is negative 2. Negative 18 divided by 6, that is negative 3. Negative 27 divided by 9, that is negative 3. And negative 48 divided by 12, that is negative 4. Okay, so there's no pattern here. Let's take a look at y times x. Well, negative 6 times 3 is negative 18. Negative 18 times 6 negative 108. I'm just going to stop right here because I can already see there is no pattern here either. Okay, so the y divided by x is not constant. The y times x is not constant. That means we have neither type of variation. And just to review, if we had a constant pattern for y divided by x or y times x, we would have either a direct variation or an inverse variation. And it's sometimes hard to remember the pattern. What I would recommend is that you just start with a basic equation like I did, y equals k times x, and then solve for k, and then start with y equals k divided by x for the inverse variation and do the same thing. And that will tell you how to calculate the constant value if there is either type of variation.